So today we are going to see how to install Koha in Windows. Okay. So I'm not going to into the detailed steps. Okay. I am just going you to show the procedure for how to install Koha in Windows. So this is all about our library automation and digital library practicals. So kindly follow this particular video, and so that you can also install it in your system. So what I am going to do is, I am in a screen, I am in the Google homepage actually. So what I am going to do is, here in the URL tab, I am going to type tech digit TECHDIGIT Koha for Windows. Okay. Remember, usually Koha is installed in Linux or Ubuntu. Okay. Windows will be used as a client, but here for localhost, for usage in our computer, we are going to install it in Windows. Okay. It is not an advanced version, it is a basic version, around 3.something only. So we will see. So for learning purpose, this is more than sufficient first. So we will see how to install it. So just type tech digit Koha for Windows, and you will see this particular link actually. Install Koha on Windows 7, either Windows 7, 8 or 10. Just click on this. It will take you to this particular website called Technical Digit. Here you will have a full installation guide on how to install Koha. Yeah, it will take depending upon your internet speed, it will take less than 10 minutes only. But the size is little bit bigger. But anyway, I'll show you. What I'll do is, now you are in this particular page, right? We have searched for Tech Digit Koha and Koha for Windows on Google search. And we came to this particular website, and what we are going to do is we are just going to click this green colored icon, download Koha for Windows. So when you click this, what will happen is automatically it will be downloaded. Or it is asking, it can't be downloaded securely, whether you want to discard or keep. Kindly click keep, that means it will download. Okay. If you discard, means it will not download. It is for security purposes. So it is around 592 MB. Okay, so nearly 600 MB. Depending upon your internet speed, it will take in my system, it took around 10 minutes. Depending upon your speed, it varies. Okay, so now I am not going to wait for the entire download setup. Okay, what I will do is, I'll just stop this. I'll cancel this, because it has already been downloaded in my particular system. So instead of wasting time, we can directly go into it. Okay, so I'll just cancel this. So when you click download, remember, when you click download, so automatically the zip file will be downloaded, and it will be available in your downloaded folder. Okay, so what you do is, so it will be available in your downloads folder, right? It will be available in your downloads folder. So it will be available here only, in the downloads folder only. So what you need to do is, in the downloads folder, since I have cancelled it, it's not here. So you have to copy it, cut this from the download folder, and you have to go to C, either Windows C or D drive or whatever drive it may be. Okay, whatever drive it may be, let it be. In my PC, I am having only one drive. Okay, only one drive C. In your laptop, you might be having different drives, like D, different partitions, D and E or whatever it may be. Go to any drive, no problem. So since I am having only one particular drive, so I am going to C. So I have pasted this Koha for Windows. So after downloading, it will look like this only. So this is the compressed zip folder. So it is compressed. The original size is around 2 to 3 GB. It is compressed to 600 MB, nearly 600 MB. So it will look like this. Now what you have to do is, you have to either right click it or double click it. We right click it like this, it will ask, since it is a zip folder, you have to extract it. Okay, so it will ask for, in Windows 7, it will ask for extract here. So you give extract here. If not, if it is asking for extract all, just give extract all and let it be like this. Okay, and click extract. Okay, And once you click extract, automatically it will start extracting. So again, I'm not going to wait for the full extraction because I have already done this. This is just to show for you. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to close this. So what happens is, see, in a new folder, it will extract in a new folder like this. Okay. Here nothing has been extracted because I have cancelled it. So I don't need this folder. Okay, fine. So let it be there, no problem. So it will extract in a new folder. Inside the folder, what will happen is, what will be there is, you will find a file like this, USR folder will be there. Inside that folder, USR folder will be there. So what you should do is, inside this Koha for Windows, you have to cut and copy the USR folder and paste it in the directory itself, in the C directory itself, okay? Because then only the USR should be pasted in the root directory. Then only it will work actually. You cannot keep it in a separate folder. So USR should be directly, it should be directly in the C or D or E, whatever it may be. So for example, when you check the path information, when I open this, I am clicking this USR. When I check the path information, it should be directly under C. Or in D also no problem, in E also no problem. Because the path of the USR should be in the C. So this is called as path, okay? This is called as path. When you double click it, you will get the path location, okay? That is a path location. It should be directly in the C directory. Okay, it should be directly placed in the USR folder, should be located in the root directory. So here for me, C is the root directory. If you are keeping it D also, no problem, fine. So it should be directly in the root directory. Do not place it under any other folder. Okay, remember that. So now after extracting, these are the files you will be having. Okay, so Apache server, MySQL and Zebra server, these are the prerequisites. Okay, Apache is a server. Okay, MySQL is the database management system in which the data regarding the software will be stored. So now what you have to do is, so after downloading it and after extracting it, what you have to do is, first thing is you have to click start MySQL server, double click it. So once you double click it, you will get a window like this and automatically it will close. Within 1 or 2 seconds, automatically it will close. So leave it. So that means your MySQL server has been started. It's like switching on a bike. When you put the key and you have to turn on the ignition, right? Then only you can drive it. Similarly, for working of Koha, you have to turn on the SQL server, okay? In order to get the data, store the data and whatever it is. So once we have started the MySQL server, next is we need to start the batch file. That is a Koha server, okay? So once you click that, what will happen is, again a command prompt window will be opened, and now you don't close this, just minimize this, okay? And then the third step is, go to Zebra server, again you click it, again you will get a command prompt window and with some codes, and again please don't close this, just minimize it. So done. Our work with starting the server and starting all other servers has been done. So now we will see whether Koha has been successfully installed or not. So how do we check that? Now I am going to take you to that particular browser. So here what you have to do is, you have to type localhost 8080. So localhost is nothing but the Koha is installed in your particular system only. It can be used locally, not globally over the web, okay? So the 80 is nothing but the port number, okay? So this is the, after installing, if you type this and hit enter, so let's see whether it is installed or not. If everything goes right, it will be installed. You will see the Koha web page, actually Koha home page of Koha. If you are getting any error message, means then something has been left out, or some server has not been started, or some files have not been installed properly. Okay, it will take some time. See, we have installed. Great, na? We have installed. Okay, so this means Koha is in our system actually. So within a matter of 10 to 15 minutes, we have installed. So depending upon the internet speed, we know we can see it will take some time. It's very easy actually. You need not to confuse and you need not to do anything. And I will later tell you what is Apache, what is MySQL, and what are the functions of those. So before going into the extra terminologies, I will just finish the Koha concept first. Okay. So this I think will be easier for you. This procedure will be easier for you to install. Okay. So this is the Koha. This is the Koha. What do you say? This is the Koha homepage. So normally the password will be admin. Password will also be admin. Remember that. Password will also be admin. Normally if you type admin, it will go, man. Okay, fine. Admin, fine. If you want, you can save it. Admin is the password. Okay. So if you want, you can change your password. That's fine. Okay. So this is the interface of Koha software, and from the next class we will definitely look into these different modules. So what is circulation module, what is serial control, acquisition, reports, tools, everything we will look at. So after this you will be able to work in Koha efficiently. Okay. So I hope you have understood how to install Koha in Windows. Okay. So now if you want to go to OPAC, you know what is OPAC, na? Open access. Just you click on this particular URL. I will share this site with you also. A step-by-step site. When you click this URL, it will take you to the OPAC actually. OPAC, that means where you can search online catalog, open access catalog. And once you add the number of books, once you add the books, that is cataloging, once you add books, you can always search in OPAC. This is your OPAC. So you can install and you can maintain your own library management system in your desktop or in your personal computer. So this is all about installing Koha. So this is all about Koha installation.